The next topic that I want to take is Alzheimer's, or you know, we forgetting everything. And why I clubbed it with the eye problems is because Alzheimer's is like the cataract of the eye. Like in the eye, when I can't see someone or somebody, I develop a cataract which is like grayness, which basically means I am feeling my life is gray. I'm not feeling that there are colors in my life. Similar way, a person who suffers from Alzheimer's basically is not a person who is stupid. He is not a person who doesn't know about life. It's an adaptation that's happening where the person wants to forget whatever has happened. Maybe he just wants to forget the people around him. He wants to forget what he did yesterday. It's almost like taking a black paint or the gray paint that had gone on the lens of the eyes. Similar way, you're taking that gray paint and painting it on the brain. What are you really doing? You're wiping off, that means the memories, are they really disappeared from there? The memories are very much there. The person just cannot have his memories the way it is because it's not doing the purpose that it should do. Our body is so beautiful that it creates adaptations which are called disease, including Alzheimer's, so that we would survive. So the question here would be, what is it that this person is seeing, smelling, tasting? What are the sounds, smells that he has preserved, or thoughts that he has preserved in his head that are not letting him live? So the only way to make him live is to blind all these areas up. It's like almost putting, like I said, tar on the road. It's like hiding those areas up. Does that mean that if we really scratch it back, that the person can get back his memories? So I've worked on a case which is very interesting, where you know, you can't talk to an Alzheimer's patient and they will not give you any much details. So you can't really do much of a talk therapy there. Interestingly, what does he? He's very, very intelligent scientist. Now, why would somebody who's as intelligent and a scientist would fail his memory? He's only remembering certain things. He doesn't want to remember the scientific bit and everything else. So he's kind of pushed back and forgotten everything. What I used over there was the Nest Health technology, and I used My Health and Infoceuticals. And today, it's so interesting to watch him. He's got back, a lot of his memory has come back. Like I said, the memory hasn't gone anywhere. It has to be safe to bring back that memory. So the safety was created by Infoceuticals to bring back that memory. Whatever the shock that had got registered in that part of the brain got dislodged with My Health, with all the work with the Infoceuticals. And what are Infoceuticals? What is My Health? My Health is a doctor's device, which is basically an instrument which you can pick up under nesthealth.com. And Nest Health work is the work that they are doing with the Infoceuticals and provision scan, which you can actually, with the scan, you can make out where exactly is the person having conflicts in his body, what is he actually thinking. And then with the Infoceuticals, you can actually, Infoceuticals are water therapy. You can actually clean up the space where all this clutter has been created. And that can then help the person to get back to more ease. Thank you so much for listening.